So this is our third video about the Evo 7 device, and here you can see, like, if you want to purchase the Evo 7, you need to click on the means you can find out it by the Google as well, and see, like, one everything you can see, like, if you want to shop it, click on the shop, and here you can see the multiple dealers are there, which and you can buy this. And with the warranty as well. So let me click on this link, and you can see here, this is a similar image which I shared with you, and the front panel and the back panel of the image you can see here, and the cost of this, you can see the cost as well, and based on the requirement, as of now you can see this is a 48 Evo 7 device. And this is 8000 series. The features and benefit here you can see, and the applications, accessibility, port access, console management, everything you can see here. So if you are purchasing the device, you need to go through it, like the port detail, power supply, warranty as well, and iOS and the cable connectivity, everything you need to check it before purchasing. Another is, you can discuss with the vendor as well, and you can discuss the requirement, and based on the your requirement, the vendor will suggest you the best product for your environment. So these are the features of this, and if you talk about the CPUs, you can see the dual core ARM Cortex, and the memory detail 1 GB DDR3L RAM, and the flash is 16 GB. So lot of things are there, and you will purchase this, and these are the SFP fibers transceivers. So let's come on the our main topic. So here we can see, like, installation, how we can installation it. So the installation process is very simple. You need to the GUI is very, very simple. CLI is also simple. Most of the time, like, most of the candidates are familiar with the GUI configuration, means you need to go on the port connectivity. Let me show you. We can see on the images, like this. Okay, so here you can I'm not able to click on the second one. Let me try it. Let me click on the other one. This was the page. It was redirected to the other one. It will be the console of this. Let me click on the visit. After visiting, so when you will access it, the okay. So by default, the admin credential will be admin for this. This is the basic configuration of this. When you first time wizard, you can see this is the first time wizard here. Let me scroll down. Okay. So this is the security profile here, and the IP configuration. Okay. So Evo 7 ACS 8000 series. Okay, so guys, you can see here, the serial port means if you are connecting the device, you need to check like on which port is free. As you can see, like these all ports are free, right? So if you want to connect your device with the port 1, what we need to do? Very simple thing. You need to click on this option. After this, the prompt will become, you need to enable this, right? Or you need to select the name of the device, right? And say to data center engineer, like, please connect that switch port to on this interface. After that, you can easily access your device, and you can reserve this for that switch, and you can reserve for any XYZ, you can reserve that. If other ports are not in use, simply disable this. That will be help you in case any next engineer want to see like which port are free. He can easily identify it. Next solution is he need to check the connectivity. He will check the access of the devices. After that, he can check like which port is free or which should not. So these all are the option here: access, system tools, system security, and DSV version, date and time, language, journal, boot configuration. You can change the boot configuration as well. On the system tool, we can say like save the configuration, restore the configuration, upgrade iOS, right? And reset factory, right? On the default configuration, you can say. And the information you can see, uses you can see on the network setting. There's all the network setting like IP version, 4 static root. These are the setting, device setting, interface level, and SNMP is there. And other thing is, these are the serial ports, port connectivity, auxiliary port, you can see here, pluggable device, right, which can be, you can connect like, and another is authentication. You can create the user as well, which I have discussed on my previous video. So we can create the multiple users and create a group as well. We can assign the permission to the group. And if we are creating any other group, and we can assign that group on the, that user on the, that group, right? So all the permission will be applied on the, that user as well. Events and log, you can see here, power management, sensors, and you can change the password as well. Is the monitoring of this device. So there is a lot of options here. If you, most of the companies are using this product to access the devices. So these all the are the path one by one, step by step. So how you will be, how you can configure your Evosent device, right? First of all, you need to turn off the device, right? And after that, connection terminals, one by one you can see all the things. If you are taking the SSH of the device, what you will see? First time wizard, the configuration will be default. You need to configure it according to us, right? IP address, host name, and the port detail, everything, DNS, NTP, everything you need to do. So this is the accessing of the console system via web UI. So what you need to do, this is a simple thing they have explained. First of all, like your connectivity should be there. Your routing should be there, and if you are using the DHCP, right, basic configuration should be there. Every network engineer aware about, like, if I am accessing any device, what is the basic step for that, right? IP address, subnet, default gateway, these are the basic thing. If you have entered the DNS detail, please mention that also. After that, what you need to do, you need to go on the web browser and just type the IP address. Suppose this is your IP address using the HTTPS, and you can the prompt will become, you can enter the credential, and after that the dashboard, you can see the dashboard. First wizard you can see. Okay, so we have discussed about the wizard screen, and you will see here, and you need to click on the expert level. After that, you can do your configuration step by step. You can do here as well, means your security setting. You need to, if you are changing the SSH version, HTTPS port number, anything, and just click on next, your network setting, your port connectivity, your user profile, and then finish or save. So same thing are there, network parameters, configuration port, all things are there. No need to like explain it in the brief. Every engineer are aware like how to configure the interface. You can enable the LDAP as well, LLDP. So administrator web GUI screen. Okay. So admin, login as a admin, either admin with the password or ever send. Okay. So this is a very important thing. And if you are accessing it via root account, the password will be Unix. Web UI screen area. Right. You can see here, these are the main thing, and the points are there, top option bar, right, refresh if you want to do the refresh, print you want to print the screen, logout, and if you need any help, you can click here.